Hello, I'm Seamus Dunhue of Eve University, and this is a demonstration of my 7 probe formation. Now, in a previous video, namely the exploration segment of the How to Survive Eve Online series, I demonstrate the basic use of core scanner probes to try and find cosmic signatures. And I filmed that series using a new alt with very low skill points, only astrometrics level 1 or 2, and as a result he could only use 4 or 5 probes at a time, respectively. For my real scanning work, however, I like to use my main character, which has astrometrics level 4, so I can use 7 probes at a time. So I am in space, in the Agfi solar system. I have an expanded probe launcher, but I currently have it loaded with core scanner probes. So, let me go to the solar map and make sure I'm on the solar system map. Alright. And let me launch. Oh, I gotta decloak first. Let me launch 7 probes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Let me hit the micro warp drive, get some distance, and cloak up again. Even in high security space, in my covert ops frigate, I try to remain cloaked as much as possible. And let me zoom in, and now I have 7 probes all overlapping on top of each other. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put them in formation. So, without holding any modifier keys, I'm going to left-click and drag one of these arrowheads. Remember that left-clicking and dragging an arrowhead allows you to move that probe back and forth only along one axis. So I'm going to move this one such that it's tip-to-tip with the rest of the probes in the middle. If you left-click and drag a surface of the box, you can move it around on a particular plane. I believe it's the XZ plane, the XY plane, or the YZ plane. So, tip to tip, and let me not zoom in or out anymore. I'm going to do the same thing with some of the other probes. So left click and drag, move it out, tip to tip, left click and drag, move it out, tip to tip, left click and drag, move it out, tip to tip, and let me change my perspective here. Left click and drag, move that out, tip to tip, left click and drag, move that out, tip to tip. I'm doing this a little bit slowly for demonstration purposes. Usually I can get that into formation a lot more quickly. I'm now going to use the mouse wheel to scroll out a little bit. Hold down the shift key, left click and drag one of the spheres, and pull it out. Let's increase that scan radius. Let go of the shift key. Hold down the option key or the alt key, depending upon whether you're Macintosh or Windows. Hold down the option key or the alt key, and left click and drag any one of the arrowheads, and that will expand the formation, or contract the formation, or completely invert it. But this is a symmetrical formation, so it doesn't matter. Let go of alt, zoom out. Shift, drag, let go of shift. Alt, drag, let go of alt, zoom out. And I will expand the formation to its maximum size. There we go. And let me toggle the user interface visibility so you can see this. That is the 7 probe formation. One in the center, one above, below, north, south, east, and west. Right. Not that I remember which of these directions is north on the F11 map browser. So, you can shift, left click and drag an arrowhead or a surface of the control box to move the entire formation at once. Let go of shift. And now I have my entire probe formation. Hold on, let me move this over. Now I have my entire probe formation centered on the solar system. It's not a particularly large solar system, so this formation can cover everything in it. Some solar systems are much bigger than this. So, I'm going to click the Analyze button. That sends the probes flying outwards. By the way, the reason there's a lot of icon clutter here, these are all bookmarks. There used to be an incursion in this constellation, so I bookmarked the incursion site beacons. They make for very nice safe spots in high security space, and in low security space, you can make safe spots in between them, but I digress. So I have a couple of different cosmic signatures, one of which appears twice. Now recall that if you have two-point solutions on the same cosmic signature, that means three probes can see it, and only three probes can see it. Right. So it's a little hard for me to tell which three probes can see this thing. But anyway, the probes that can see it thinks that this cosmic signature, that's NNK-291, has to be here or here. So what I'm going to do, look at my formation axis on, and shift, left click and drag the formation to try and center it on the gap in between those two signals. Let go of the shift key. Shift, left click and drag again. There we go. I now have the formation, the center of the formation, in between those two signals. And I can shift, left click and drag, drop the scan radius, then alt click and drag, move all the probes in, and then scan again. So I like to use the 7-probe formation, usually because it gives me nice symmetrical coverage in all directions. So if I want to center the probe formation on an area of interest, I'm not likely to miss something all of a sudden because the formation is lopsided or something. Okay. So now I have NNK-291. My probes think it's approximately there, so I'll shift the formation. Now I have astrometric everything up to level 4. So astrometric's 4, astrometric acquisition 4, astrometric rangefinding 4, astrometric pinpointing level 4. Because of my high skills in astrometrics and the fact that I'm using a Kovops ship, which is bonused for scan probe strength, I usually drop down to radius settings at a time. So I'm going to go straight from 16 down to 4, and then collapse the formation, and then zoom in. So I can do this to radius settings at a time. At lower skill points, you may need to be more cautious because scan deviation is likely to be big enough that you're going to completely miss the cosmic signature that you're trying to look for. Alright. Center the formation on the new signal. Drop the scan another two radius settings. So go from 4 to 1. Move in the probes. Analyze. And there we have a magnetometric site, a looted angel collision site. If I actually want to run this, I'm going to need to go in there with an analyzer, a salvager, and there might be rats to fight, so I may need combat support. But now I have that signal. I can right-click on it. I can bookmark the location if I want to. I'm not interested, so I'm going to leave it alone. Now I'm doing it a little bit slow for demonstration purposes. There's one other cosmic signature in this solar system as of the time of filming. So let me demonstrate how quickly I can do this. So I found NNK-291. Let me find the other one. No explanation, no slowing down this time. This is about as fast as I can do it. Alright, that is an unstable wormhole. And I can right-click on it, and I can warp to it. High-security space, I'll usually warp to it within 20 kilometers. Low or null-security space, I might warp to it at some weird distance. Let me change my default distance as an example. 40 kilometers is not a default distance, so right-click this wormhole, warp to within 40 kilometers.
Warp drive active.
And there were no other cosmic signatures, so I'm going to recover my probes. And there is the wormhole, a K162, which means it's the generic exit, so I don't know what type of wormhole it really is. I can show info on it. It seems to lead into unknown parts of space. This wormhole seems to lead into unknown parts of space. That means it's a class 1, 2, or 3 wormhole system on the other side. This wormhole's beginning to decay and probably won't last another day. That's at least several hours, probably 4 or 6 hours or something like that. This wormhole has not yet had its stability significantly disrupted by ships passing through it. So however much mass tolerance this wormhole has, it's got at least half of it remaining. So now I would right-click the wormhole, bookmark the location. J, I have no idea what this is. C1-3. A wormhole, I don't know what type this is, inbound, and the scan ID is SBY-549. Alright. So I don't know where it goes, I don't want to know what type of wormhole it leads, just that it leads to a class 1, 2, or 3, and that it opened from the other side. So somebody else found this thing before I did. So that's a demonstration of my 7 probe formation, I hope you found this useful. In the meantime, thank you for watching.